You know, investing in the community, well, right today we're interviewing right here among all the exhibits in our Energy Education Center. And these are available for schools and community groups to come by and tour and look and learn a lot about energy and nuclear power. Right next door we have the auditorium that has been used for many functions and will continue to be used. It's available to the communities in the area for organized functions. There's so many ways that we want to stay involved, but this is a physical presence. You know, Palo Verde is also very excited to be part of the partnership with WestMEC and Australia Community College. We're building a vocational training center right across the street from here. This will be a great opportunity for the students to further their skills and to take their futures to the next level so they have opportunities for good jobs in the future.
So we all have a stake in the success of Buckeye. We've got to get Buckeye right. If Buckeye doesn't become a key job driver in our region, then we will all be losing out on important opportunities into the future. If we're going to bring large-scale manufacture, quality manufacturing, advanced manufacturing to our region, there are unique opportunities in a city like Buckeye. And I believe from the bottom of my heart, and I know Mayor Mech believes it from the bottom of his heart, that a growing and thriving and improving Buckeye is great for Phoenix and vice versa. Both of our cities need to succeed for the other one to succeed. We really do act as a team in this region, and Buckeye is a key player on our team.
Most of you all know the F-35, America's newest fighter, is coming to Luke Air Force Base. We've got the first one on the ramp right now, and over the next 10 years, one decade, we may be growing up to 144. That is currently the approved plan. Now, we're going to still need to keep flying over Buckeye like we do down to our ranges each and every day. I don't think you're going to see much of a difference, though. The noise of the F-35 will not be much appreciably different than it is with the F-16 today. And the total numbers of airplanes that we're going to have flying here over the next 10 years is going to stay roughly about the same, because as we grow with the F-35, we will slowly decrease the number of F-16s. So I don't think you're going to see a whole lot of change on the flying front. On the jobs front, we expect to grow probably 500 to 700 more jobs here on the base over the next 10 years. And those are opportunities for Buckeye residents. Those are opportunities that folks on the base may be looking for places to live down in Buckeye. And those, I think, will be the big impacts of the F-35.
We plan to continue to be a major part of this community in all aspects. As Buckeye and the West Valley grows, we intend to grow our community partnership as we safely and efficiently generate electricity for the long term, right here in Buckeye.